Welcome, Goodwood SpeedWeek, to Alauda Aeronautics here in Adelaide, South Australia, where we're going to give you a preview, the first sneak peek of our full-size speeders. Here at Alauda Aeronautics, we're working on the world's first flying racing car. We're in the middle of a mobility revolution right now. What we're doing is creating a racing series to catalyze that industry. Airspeeder is the race to create the ultimate flying car. When we look back at pioneers like Ford and Rolls and Renault, Marcel Renault was a racing driver. Charles Rolls was a racing driver. Henry Ford was a racing driver and used his winnings from racing to start the Ford Motor Company. The first Fiats were racing cars. The first Bentleys were racing cars. The first Mercedes was a racing car. So it stands to reason that in this century, the first flying cars that truly change the world will be racing cars. The future of mobility is obviously electric. We're getting electric planes, we're getting electric multicopters, and those same trends that are driving electric vehicles and autonomous vehicles are going to be driving air taxis and electric mobility in the sky. We believe that racing is going to be the great catalyst to propel the industry forward. The Airspeeder mission is to be the race that creates the ultimate flying car. That race, we want it to be motorsport in the sky. Multiple vehicles starting together in the air at the same time. This is not a new air race. This is motorsport in the sky. Being based in South Australia, we've been incredibly lucky to have been able to keep moving while COVID has raged around the world. We're very fortunate to have our engineering team based in South Australia. The South Australian state government, I'm very grateful to them for managing the pandemic. And so we've been lucky enough to keep moving and keep producing vehicles. Over the last few months, we've been hard at work putting together our Mark III prototypes. The Mark III is our first full-scale design, and we're incredibly excited to show the world its first look at the Mark III and what Airspeeder is going to look like. So let's go take a look. So this is it. This is the Mark III. For the past couple of years, we've been working on the Mark II, which was a three-quarter scale proof of concept. The Mark III is now a full-scale prototype. This is Grant Hiller, our senior aerospace engineer. Grant, you want to tell us a little bit about Mark III and what it means to us?
So as Matt said, this is our Mark III. It's our first full-scale unmanned vehicle. So we're using this to really test the performance and push the envelope of what we want to achieve in the race series. So we're going to be testing the maneuverability of the vehicle, figuring out the performance, and then we're going to lead into the Mark IV man program. So we're going to start validating all of the different safety features on the Mark III. So we're going to be looking at introducing LiDAR, radar, and machine vision to form a collision avoidance systems where we're going to create a virtual force field over the vehicle to keep the pilot safe, but also allow really close quarter motorsport action.
Do you want to tell us a bit about the body and the chassis kind of configuration and how that's going to evolve?
Yeah, so the Mark III here is a full carbon fiber structure, but we're then going to evolve into a full monocoque structure for the Mark IV. So it's going to be really lightweight, strong, and also extremely safe for the pilots.
So there's a software collision avoidance layer for safety, and then there's a mechanical safety layer in the monocoque. Aviation in general has, you know, it's a bit of a beast. It moves quite slowly because there are very rigorous certification programs. But racing in aviation can move a bit faster.
Yeah, that's the beauty of it. So in the Airspeeder race series, we can really push the boundaries each season, introduce new technologies, rapidly evolve, and really make the whole thing safer, but also keeping it really exciting for the viewers.
Thanks very much, Grant. And now we'll talk about batteries. So talking about powertrain, this is Annie Mossman. Annie is a mechanical engineer, joins us at the start of the year and was previously on the Queen's University Formula SAE team. Building race cars, combustion and then electric. And a big part of what you've been doing is upgrading our powertrain, upgrading the batteries from the Mark II to the Mark III.
One of the key things I've been looking at is one of the The hardest points is the ESCs, so the electronic speed controllers. One of the biggest challenges with where we're at right now is that nobody's designing those parts, so we kind of have to match the system as best we can and then go, all right, now can we create something custom that's going to be better than this? The other thing that I'm doing is redesigning the battery. That really started as a safety factor. That was one of the main focuses, and then also increasing the power. So this new battery should have 95% increase in available capacity with only a 50% increase in weight. One of the biggest issues with our previous design was actually the connections. You'd have to have somebody go up and disconnect four different connections before the battery was fully off power. So the new system is slide and lock. Basically, the connections are part of the system. You slide the battery in, it locks in to the frame. It's a prototype design, but this is what we're aiming towards, to be able to have it quick in, quick out. It both adds that safety factor of not having somebody need to be near the vehicle for very long at all. And also it means you've got quick pit stops. Somebody can come in, unload a battery, load another battery, you're back out flying, racing, getting in there.
Obviously we're building a racing series, and when we're circuit racing, we're going to be changing out those batteries in electric pit stops. So a really essential part of that is to be able to get in, get out really fast. And yeah, you don't want to spend 20 minutes changing batteries in the middle of a race.
Especially with those 6 minutes performance batteries.
Yeah, exactly. There's a lot of changes.
So what you have to do is really design how much power do you need, how long do you need to be flying, what performance do you need, so that you can have as little battery as possible to get you that distance and to get you the performance that you need to make it there as quickly as possible. So you'd actually have different designs of batteries depending on what kind of section of race you're looking at. If you're looking at something where you've got a bunch of dynamic high performance moves, but it's really short, you want a small battery in there just to get you through that section. Keeps your vehicle light, keeps you agile. Similar to Formula One, where it's not just a race. There's other systems, there's other things involved. It's not just about how fast you can fly.
So to give everyone context for what kind of power is in a Mark III, these battery packs have 560 kilowatts max available power. That's the same max power as the battery pack that's in a Porsche Taycan Turbo S. So 560 kilowatts is an enormous amount of power to be able to deliver instantaneously.
Yeah, you know, instantaneous power is what you need to make those quick adjustments in the air, so.
Exactly, and if we compare that to, that Porsche weighs 2.3 tons, this weighs under 100 kilos without anything in it. So, enormous amount of power in a very, very light package. And hey, it's a mobility revolution. We don't just have to build taxis.
Yeah, we can have fun too.
Awesome, thanks very much, Annie. Now we're off to look at the design of the Mark IV and what's to come.
Je suis ici avec Félix Piron. Que faites-vous dans la vie, Félix?
So I'm the vehicle designer at Airspeeder, and I'm the one who designed the Mark IV concept. So the way I met Matt, I showed him my personal thesis project, which was basically an electric seaplane inspired by the car industry. So it was supposed to look like a sort of flying car with seaplane technology.
The parallels between what we're trying to do and the iconic designs of the Schneider Trophy, the seaplanes racing around Monaco at the turn of last century, that's definitely the kind of ethos that we wanted for in our design language. One of the things I love about what Felix has done here is to merge a whole lot of different DNA into one package. So when you look at this, you kind of instinctively know that's something new, but it's familiar.
Yeah, so the Speeder is essentially a mix of a Formula One from the 60s, a GT sort of car, like an Aston Martin or a Jaguar E-Type, and a multicopter, an octocopter. So the biggest challenge was to combine everything together to make it still appealing visually and still efficient from an engineering point of view.
One of the things that excites me the most about this design is when people look at it, from all over the world, people look at this and go, it's something totally new, but it's also weirdly familiar.
So my challenge was to combine everything together and to make it look still appealing and you know, visually striking for anyone who would look at it. And I think that's what's so unique with Airspeeder is that we create something from scratch. And for me as a designer, it's a unique opportunity to design something with very little rules, basically. I start from a blank piece of paper. I have you know, basic ideas of you know, design constraints. But other than that, it's you know, feel free to design whatever you want. And if we had to compare ourselves to the auto industry, this is pure innovation. We are not constrained by four wheels or by a square frame. We are starting and at the moment leading an entirely new market, which is the market of racing flying vehicles.
That's very rare in the auto industry and the aviation industry. So what the opportunity that we have right now to do something inspiring is, it's incredible. And we won't see this again for maybe another 100 years. You know, the opportunity to define the shapes that of the icons. So I think I kind of see it as, it's fantastic, it's a lot of fun, but it's also a kind of responsibility. We're creating the things that people will look back on and go, that was the golden age. You know, we've got to do well. Or, you know, it's a strange looking...
Strange mix, yeah. Mechanical creature. That's not what we want. We still want something iconic, well-crafted, obviously, super lightweight, super fast, and super sexy.
Absolutely.
Awesome. Thanks, Felix. And thank you, Goodwood SpeedWeek, for tuning in. It's been a pleasure to show you a little bit of what we've been working on here on the other side of the world. Stay tuned, follow us at airspeeder.com. We're gonna be up in the air soon and racing before you know it. See you.